What's the number one TV show?
This is us.
This is us.
Hello.
Who's the
Hello,
star of
Sam.
The number one TV show? Mandy Moore.
Hi, Mandy.
Who's here this morning? We're so happy to have her. You're on the set last night.
Yes.
Do you guys just look at each other and go, we're on the number one TV show?
No. We do look at each other and go, we are so unbelievably grateful to be a part of this ride. Like, it's the greatest job I've ever had in 18 years of being in this industry. I'm grateful every day to go to work.
And what makes it the greatest job?
The people, first and foremost. Like, we have the best cast and crew and our writers. Like, we really truly are, and without sounding cheesy,
right,
like a big family. We really are. We love each other. And the writing is so exceptional and elevated. Like, it makes our job as actors so much easier.
But you know what? Elevated is the exact right word. And I tell you what, sometimes shows have this dilemma with that quote unquote sophomore season.
Mm-hmm.
But that has not happened here.
No.
Did you have any trepidation about that?
I didn't. No, I really trust Dan Fogelman, who created our show, and all of our writers. Like, we knew that, you know, we had 18 episodes in the first season to sort of establish who these characters were in these different stories. And we knew that season two was going to be a bit darker. But I think people are excited to be on the ride and figure out where we're going with these stories.
And do you know where it's going?
I do.
Oh, wow.
I don't know every single detail.
Okay.
But I know sort of, I have a ballpark idea. Like,
right.
we sit down at the beginning of the season, and actually just a few weeks ago, I went in the writer's room and was like, can you just lay it out for me for the rest of the season?
Yeah.
Like, what I'm doing, like, how many days am I going to have to be in that old age prosthetic makeup?
Right.
Like, I want to know those details. So I went and sort of got like the whole skinny on everything.
I don't say this very often. You're literally beaming.
Aww.
And there was that lovely color cover of People magazine. It's like, Mandy Moore's happiest perfect life.
No.
You're going to be a bride?
I'm going to be a bride.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Can we come to the wedding?
I'll tell you about it after.
Okay, fair enough.
I'll give you all the details after.
That was the honest response. How did you crazy kids meet?
We met because of Instagram.
Really?
Isn't that so
it works.
Silly and modern? I know. It's like they should market themselves as a dating app now.
Okay, so who contacted?
Yeah, he's in a band, and I heard one of their songs on the radio, didn't know anything about them or the band, and I posted a picture. This was a few years ago on Instagram, and he saw it and then found sort of a sneaky way to contact me, and we sort of started corresponding that way and then went out on a date.
So who is he? What band? I'm sorry.
Oh, no. They're in a little indie band called Dawes, and his name's Taylor, and he's from LA. He grew up here, and he's just the greatest thing that's ever happened to me.
Oh.
Yeah, he's the best.
It's all love. Do you just, every night, is it a prayer before bed, or do you cry into a Kleenex, or what happens?
I'm just really grateful. Every day I wake up like but life is crazy, and you guys know this business. Like, there are ebbs and flows, and I'm 33 years old. I've been doing this since I was 15. And I've had my share of ups and downs personally and professionally. And you know when that wave is sort of, when you're on the crest of it, like, it gives you that newfound appreciation when you've been on the other side of it. And so I'm grateful every day for everything that's going on and appreciating it.
It is the mature Mandy Moore. And now a clip from This Is Us. Do you watch the show when it airs?
We do. Yeah, we all
do. Do you do together?
You know, before the episodes air, Milo and I usually go to Dan's office. We went yesterday and actually watched the last episode that aired this week because Milo hadn't seen it. But we have this massive like group text where there's like 10 of us on like a text chain, and we talk like 50 times a day.
Oh,
we're always like, sending like gifts back and forth to each other and being goofy. Yeah.
All right, here from NBC is This Is Us look.
Hi, Paula.
Oh.
How are you?
Good. How are you doing?
Right in here. Take your seat. This is leftover from yesterday. No, we don't usually give Randall too much sugar. I just figured for a first birthday.
Rebecca, your kids can have birthday cake. I won't hold it against you.
Okay, thanks.
So the judge, he has all this paperwork.
Yes, along with my glowing recommendation. Now, this next part is just a formality. You'll go before Judge Bradley, and he'll ask you a few questions like, do you wish to adopt this child? And you'll say, yes, we do.
We need to commemorate.
No, babe,
moment.
I don't think we need any
more. We need pictures. We need new pictures.
We're going to get new pictures.
Okay.
Is there some great guy in the background just playing the guitar?
In my mind, there is.
Right.
Yes. I know how the score is all going to be laid out.
But the music really adds a wonderful component to
it. It does. Yeah. Sid, our composer's just, beyond. Every component of the show, it works.
You're doing a deal with American Express.
I am.
For Friendsgiving.
Friendsgiving.
Okay.
Do you celebrate Friendsgiving?
That means you invite your friends for Thanksgiving?
Yes. It's sort of the new modern way to sort of celebrate the holiday. And I've been doing it for the last couple of years. So I've partnered with Amex. And
I love it because you can choose your friends, but you can't choose your family.
You can't choose your,
yeah,
absolutely.
Yeah, this is
true. Exactly. Yeah. So this year, no, I've partnered with Amex and their Blue Cash preferred card. And so you get cash back on all kinds of things that you buy every day, like groceries. And I'm going to be co-hosting this year with my soon-to-be mother-in-law.
Oh.
So I feel like there's like a little bit more pressure.
Wow,
but
yeah. How many people do we intend to have?
There's going
to
be about 40 people.
Oh, 40? Boy.
Yeah.
So what are you making?
Well,
you
I'm not taking care of the turkey or anything.
Okay.
But I'm going to bring like a sweet potato side dish, and then I'm going to bring like a typical LA, like a paleo pumpkin pie.
Oh, geez.
That's my contribution.
All right. Okay. How does one do a paleo pumpkin pie?
It's just made with almond flour.
Okay, of course.
Yeah, it's easy, yeah.
40 people, you have room for us.
Yeah. Guys, you probably want to celebrate with your own family.
That's a lot of card tables and folding chairs. 40.
It's more. That's what I love about like Friendsgiving. Yeah. It's a little bit more casual, kind of the potluck vibe, and it makes it feel like people can come and go, and come for just drinks or come for pie afterwards. And there's not like that sit down formality of it.
All right. Here's a question you are not expected to know the answer to.
Okay.
Sometimes Grey's Anatomy, I think, has run for 13 years. Sometimes people do a show and they literally know, you know what, this is a 2-3-4 year show.
Yeah.
Do you have a sense one way or another?
I don't. We talk about that. I mean, if we're so fortunate enough, maybe like 6 seasons or something. I mean, there's infinite ways to sort of tell this story. Mm-hmm. And we've already explored, obviously, like going back in time, and perhaps we'll go forward in time. Like there's a multitude of different ways to watch these characters unfold and to meet new people and bring them into these stories. But I'll do it as long as they want us to, as long as there's like good stories to tell. Right. Yeah.
Mandy, really good to see you this
morning. Good to see you as well. Thanks for having me.